Hi and welcome back to the channel. In this video we're going to do a cone development and then we're going to intersect the cone about halfway up and do a pattern of that. So starting off with our baseline. Center point. Vertical line through the middle. Then we set our base distance using the radius. Let's grab an arc. Then the height of the cone. From that apex down to the base, we then draw our cone. So to develop the pattern from that, we now break up the semicircle on the bottom using our 30-60 square. One 30, one line at 60, one 60, I got there in the end, and 130. So now we've broke that up. We then bring those marks vertically up to the baseline. We then transfer those marks up to the apex. Then with our compass on the apex to the side of the cone, we then scribe an arc, which is our baseline for our pattern. We then set our compass to the division. Each one should be equal. So as a check, just check that against the other one. That's okay, so then we'll mark these up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So now this is the start of our pattern, so that will be our point one. So then with our segments, we're now plotting the length of the base of the cone. Marking these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, and then back down to 6, 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. Obviously we've got an extra one there. So from point one back to the apex, that now is our full pattern for a complete cone. So cut that out, roll it up, makes that cone. So now if we intersect our cone, we now need to plot that onto our pattern. So each one of those intersection lines that hits our intersection, we have to bring them horizontally across to be able to get the true length line of those marks. So each one is brought horizontally out to the outside of the cone. And then with our compass on the apex, we pick up each one of those points and we scribe it around our template. That should be line number 7. So now from our intersections, we now need to join those to the apex. Working all the way around. Last one. So now working from our point one, so that's point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and point 7. So now each one of those points, so point one on there, point one on there meets there. Point 2 to point 2 meets there. Point 3 to point 3 meets there, and so on. 4, 5, 6, 7 at the top, so 7, and then working back down to 6, 5, 4, 3, 2 and point 1. So now we join those up with a nice fluid motion. That completes the pattern for a cone with an intersection. So thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.